All right, so a little bit of a disclaimer on this one. I made this video when I was sick, so my voice is slow and I sound sick. The other fun part about this one is that the kids get involved, so enjoy this.
So now it's time to build the horizontal stabilizer, which starts with the frame. Laying out all the pieces, and the spars are the I-beams that go in the front and the back, and the ribs are the ones that go in between. I like to watch where Ruby sits and moves around in these videos. Ruby is the dog, by the way. And you'll see me checking and rechecking the instructions, which are in the piece of paper in front of me. Make sure I have all the parts oriented the right way.
Time for the next present. I mean part. Got the skins for horizontal stabilizer. And the first step is to put on our first ring and inspection cover plate. So something different, should be cool. After you actually have to cut off this little tabs first.
The next step, or the first step, I should say, of attaching the skins to the frame is pretty exciting. You have to cleco the skins, and a cleco are those little copper-colored things that you put in with a little they're like spring-loaded, and they're like a temporary rivet, so they hold the skin down to the frame. And then you have to match drill a whole bunch of the holes. Match drilling is where there's a hole in the skin, but there's not a hole in the spar underneath it, so you have to take the drill through the hole in the skin and make the hole into the spar in the same location under it. Then you get to take all the clecos out and deburr both sides of the skin and both sides of the spar and polish the whole thing. Polish, polish, deburr, deburr. And if you watch very carefully, I'm going to flip this thing over right before your very eyes. And we get to do the entire process again on the other side. Watch closely. Oh, there she goes. So, here we go again with match drilling all the way across the front spar, all the way across the rear spar. Then take out all the clecos, pull the skins off, and polish some more. Deburr. And the nice thing about doing this whole process this way is you get to build the thing at least three times before you do something irreversible. Meaning, like, put a rivet in. Once you put a rivet in, if you have to fix it, you have to drill them out. I've only had to do that, like, two or three times, so it's not too big of a deal. Take the skins off. Use the shop vac, clean the place up. And get the skins back on the frame. This part is called dimple dyeing. It's where you put little dimples in the sheet metal so that the rivets that go in that location are countersunk. And so they sit down into the skin so that they don't stick up on the skin. After this, it was time for me to take the boys to the hangar for the first time, the fort as we call it. So we had to turn on all the party lights. And the boys being Jack, my son Jack, he's 14, my nephew Patrick, he's 12. And my other nephew, Davey, he's 8. Needless to say, they...
What happened with this?
Stick your finger in there.
It's not a playhouse.
Is it like the fucking I find one?
No, Davey, it's the ultimate playhouse!
We don't cut people's fingers off.
Yes, we do. That's Jacko's job.
Okay, go cut them out.
Since they were discussing cutting each other's fingers off, I thought we might as well go ahead and put them to work, and they can start with deburring.
Deburring the spars of the horizontal stabilizer. Yeah. All right, bro, give me the tool belt tour, please.
All right. Well, this isn't all on my tool belt. So we got this buffer thing for when you mess up a drill thing and I have to buff it. That goes in the tool belt and that thing goes in the back. And then in the back we have tool knife thing.
Dude, that is a sweet belt.
And then this is for if one of the rivets doesn't fit. Sometimes if you take that and you push it down in the hole, it'll realign it. And then these are to take out the clecos. So you open it up and you put these in there and that comes out. And then this is a rivet gun, so it takes...
Got any ready?
So this is the big rivet gun, and it takes these, and you put them in the holes, so they go like that, and then you put it in the hole, and you unwind it, and you push down, and then you pull the trigger. That.
Gotta love the music selection there, that's for sure. Anyway, so for the rest of the day and evening, we went around and around and around the horizontal stabilizer, putting in rivets, and as you put in the rivets, you take out the clecos. We finished this up tonight, and now it's time to go.